Hey, I wrote a blog post about measurement of our progress a few weeks ago, and I decided to record the video anyway because it's such a hot subject. And I even did an analysis of what's going on in the area of project management, of agile project management, and found out that so many people right now talk about performance revolution. They're saying that we should stop measuring the progress of people, stop measuring results of what. Let's talk about programmers, what programmers are doing. So we should not put numbers on people. So we should not measure how productive is this person comparing to another person, and maybe even not comparing teams and not comparing anything. And they are saying that this is the revolution is coming. They have articles about that. They have books written about that, that metrics are actually making they only hurt instead of helping the management, the performance, employees, and everybody else. I strongly disagree with that, and that's why I decided to publish a blog post, because I think that the revolution is needed, definitely, but in a completely different direction. I think that we must understand the difference between bad metrics and good metrics, and between the situation where the management is actually managing something and the situation when the management is only observing the reality. There are two different types of management and two different types of situations. The proper management, the good manager, is the one who knows what's going to happen tomorrow. This is the job of a manager, to predict the future. And I'm saying that on the blog many times. So the ability to predict the future is what's coming out of a good project management. When you collect everything, when you collect the understand the scope, you collect information about risks, about cost, about quality metrics, and then you put all of this together, and then you know what's going to happen in the future. And it's very important to, of course, rely on numbers. You have to put your predictions, you have to base your predictions on some numbers, on some metrics. What else you can call the numbers? Metrics. And if you don't have metrics, then you're not predicting the future. You're just observing the current, the present. And of course, you're not a project manager in this case. All you can do is basically inform your management, the sponsor of the project, about the reality, the situation, but you can never predict what's going to happen. So in this case, you're not a manager. So metrics are very important. The question is, how do we actually put a number on a person? How do we associate a number with somebody and not ruin so much the team spirit, not offend people, not make them demotivated instead of motivated? And the answer is in separating and segregating bad metrics from good metrics. For example, let's say this is a very classic example, that lines of code. If we just count the lines of code written by one programmer and lines of code written by another programmer, then most probably we're not gonna be very helpful with this metric, and probably gonna do bad things to the team instead of good things, because they will start competing with the size of code they write, not with the quality of it, not with the functionality they produce. So it's going to ruin everything. That's a bad metric. But they also exist good metrics. And when people say that all metrics are bad, that no matter how we measure the performance of our employees, we hurt them, then they basically don't understand the management. So bad metrics are bad metrics, and I can give you multiple examples of those metrics, bad metrics. But good ones, they are very important and they're necessary. Without metrics, in my opinion, the management, like I said, is just simply observation of the reality instead of planning the future. I gave a number of examples of good metrics on the blog post. For example, we can count, let's say, the amount of, this is my favorite metric, the amount of pull requests merged. When you have a team of programmers and all of them in good teams, they all contribute through pull requests, through merge requests, and all of these pull requests, they definitely pass code review steps, so they are being reviewed by other programmers, and after the review, they get merged. And the more people manage to create those requests, the more they manage to send to the repository, the better they are during this period of time. Of course, remember, we're not measuring people, we're measuring their performance. A good, very good person, a very good programmer, can be a low performer during this period of time. And the other way around, somebody who knows very little about the technology and is not very, very well educated and junior, during this period of time, may be very high performance. So we measure the performance, and this metric is one of the good examples how you measure the performance of a programmer by the amount of contribution such a programmer does. And of course, people say that not all pull requests are equal in size, not all of them are the same complexity, functionality. That's all true. But if you measure the long period of time, like, I don't know, 3 months, and then 3 months for another person, and you see that one person is contributing approximately 10 pull requests a week, and another person is doing one pull request a week, then most probably you're dealing with two different kind of performance. So probably the first one is a high performance, and the second one is maybe just lazy. So I'm strongly in favor of metrics, and I'm strongly against the idea that metrics hurt. They don't hurt, they help if they are good. If they are objective, if they are reasonable, then they only help programmers to be motivated, to be happy, to enjoy the project they work in, and to win. How exactly it helps, probably we can discuss some other time, but in general, overall, the metrics revolution is total nonsense. Don't listen to that. Thanks for listening. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.